Hey guys, what's up? Yeah, obviously you see a change in something, but I don't know what it is. Let's guess all at once. My eye makeup. No. Well, it is different because it's with a palette, which is for a separate video. But anywho, yeah. So obviously you can see my hair is red. Again, I couldn't stay away from it. I love it entirely too much to get rid of it, and yeah, and also the purple streaks that are right here and right here that are pretty much even-ish on both sides. But anyway, that's not what this video is about, though I do love it and admire it such. And stuff. But anyway, I don't even know what I'm doing. Way back, yes I do. This is a long-awaited video in my mind anyway that I've been meaning to do for a while now. And it's my nail polish collection. The last time I think I had to have to go on YouTube and even look, because I would have to go to the depths of hell to find it, which would make me go back almost to the beginning-ish of my channel, I think. I'm actually gonna look for it right now, just because I just want to see a date for it. Go all the way down. I'll hit that button and see what it does. Okay. So it's been January 18th, 2012 is when I made my last nail polish collection video. It is now March 1st, 2013. 1 o'clock in the fucking morning, mind you, but that's besides the point. When I'm making this fucking video a year and a couple months later, and oh look, it's expanded so much. I will actually link that video below, and I actually think I have, yeah, I have red hair in that video too, but it's not as vibrant as this, obviously, and my surroundings have changed, and everything's kind of moved, and you know, it is what it is. But anyway, I don't even know where to fucking start. I have it all separated basically like by the brand of nail polish and the different variations of the like the collections, I guess, within the one brands. But yeah, I'm just gonna fucking jump into it because I'm just gonna sit here and babble for fucking 20 minutes. So I'm gonna start with Revlon because Revlon are some of my favorite nail polishes, or the ones that are Revlon brand. And I have seven of those, and two of them I got recently. Everything else is stuff that I've got a few months ago or whatever, a couple months ago and beyond and shit. So, first one is a Revlon one called Peach Petal. And Peach Petal is seriously just a really light pink color. It's like no shit. Like, I don't know if this light will help it at all. Probably not. But looks like that. It's seriously, it almost looks white, but it's actually pink. Like a really light version of pink, but still. That one's called Peach Petal. And I got this one a few days ago. This one's called Sweet Tart by Revlon, and it's a really, really hot pink nail polish. Again, I'm gonna put the fucking light down so you can probably see the true brightness of it. That is the actuality of the color, and I apparently just got yellow on my hand for some reason or another. That was cool. Anyway, the next one is another, more of a cotton candy pink, and this one's Temptress. That yellow is pissing me off. And my fucking polish remover is across the room. So I'm just gonna try to sit here and scrape it off, because it's weird. Because I was trying to... Oh, it's on my desk. Okay, I have nail polish swatches all over my desk, because I was just messing with them. Just to remember how the finish was on it. Now I have polish fucking everywhere. Because I just set one of the pink ones in it, so that's cool. But, anyway, this one's called Craving Coral, and it's like pretty much an orange kind of color. Like a darker orange-ish color. The next one is called Popular, like no shit, Popular. And it's kind of like a pink-tinted nail polish. Looks a little white, but you can tell it's got the same... like peach petal color to it. Where it looks white but has a pink tinge. There's a lot of smaller glitter and like bigger chunks of glitter within it. It looks like some kind of Easter shit. I don't know. This one's called No Shrinking Violet. I've used the shit out of this and it's a really pretty dark purple color. And I'm okay with it. And this one is Blue Lagoon. And it's like a mint blue color. Or a baby blue. Whatever you prefer, I guess. Ouch. But anyway, the next set of different brand, which I'm sure anybody that wears nail polish that's been anywhere around Walgreens knows what Sinful Colors is. I have 5 of those. Starting with this one called Unicorn, which is like a weird yellow color. I don't understand, but, you know, it is what it is. And this one is called Secret Admirer. And it's like a black with a shit ton of gray and silver sparkle within it. The next one is Midnight Blue, which is a dark blue. Midnight Blue? Holy shit. Next one is... try to fix the lighting a little bit so I'm more illuminated so I don't have to put the light right on the camera. The next one is Pinky Glitter, which, no shit, it's like a pink fucking... clear nail polish. Basically, it's a pink with like no pigment to it whatsoever, with a shit ton of fucking multicolored glitter in it. So Pinky Glitter fucking fits that a lot. And this one is Frenzy, and this one is basically a clear polish with a lot of bright purple and bluish aqua colored glitter within it. Or teal glitter, whatever you fucking prefer to say. Next thing, I have 3 Maybelline nail polishes. 2 of them are the older express finish kinds. This one is Onyx Rush, and it's seriously just a jet black nail polish, which is one of my favorites because it dries the fastest. This other one is called Denim Dash, and it's a really pretty blue, very similar to the Sinful Colors one. Like, if I put them side by side, they look pretty similar. And this one is the only Maybelline Color Show one that I have, and I actually spilled some on my carpet because I was painting my nails on my floor, and I dumped a little on my carpet. So that's why there's not a lot in it, but... this one is Pink Shock, and it's actually a really pretty hot pink color. This one dries really fast, but the only downside to it is it chips like fucking crazy, so I like them, I would buy more of them, but, you know, the chipping kind of detracts me a little bit. And then the next fucking brand is something that I have way too fucking much of, in all honesty. And I'm gonna get more, so don't worry. It's Wet n Wild, which I am addicted to, like a crackhead loves crack. Because not only are they cheap, but they do work really well. They're pretty much true to color. They stay on. The cheaper ones don't dry as fast, but the ones that are like a dollar-ish more generally dry a little faster, but they all have basically the same like staying power on your nails as far as not chipping, not fucking coming off in big giant chunks and fucking smearing everywhere. They're pretty good with that, so. I have a shit ton of the Wild Shine ones, which are generally like the 99-cent ones. And this one is Tickled Pink, which is a baby pink color. Like, no shit. Next one is Bayou Blue. And that one's just like a lighter blue, teal kind of thing. This one is Hallucinate, and it's literally just a glitter polish with a lot of multicolored glitter within it. This one is Wild Card. Like a medium lightish purple, somewhere between there. This one is Rain Check. And the thing got, I used it a lot. It doesn't look like a lot because you really don't have to use much with these, but yeah, that's the only thing that bugs me about this particular kind is that it rubs off really easy. But though the name is on the sticker on the back, it kind of annoys me when they don't have a front to them. Because I sit here and go, ah, ha, 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 and rub it off. But, anyway, the next one is Burgundy Frost, which is another favorite of mine because I love reds of all kinds. Obviously. It's pretty much everywhere around my room. And this one, Burgundy. That's all I can say. A really pretty deep red. This one's Metallica, which is just a silver, grayish, shimmery, fucking bright, extravagant. Okay, I'm gonna sit here and stop describing shit and get on with it, but it's silver and it's sparkly, so. This one is Lady Luck, and it's a hot pink, because I have a thing for hot pink nail polish. Caribbean Frost, which is also kind of like a teal color, more teal than the other one. This one's Blue Moon, and it's like a really deep bluish purple color. More blue, but it's got like purple tones in it. This one is Dream Poppy, which looks pink, and then looks orange, and then looks pink, and then looks orange. So I can never tell what color it is. Maybe it's coral. I don't know. This one is just literally called Red Red. This shit's more red than my hair might be. Interesting. That's a challenge. This one's Lavender Pearlescent. It's a really pretty shimmery pink color, which obviously you can tell I've used it a lot. You can see the line about right there where I've used it. And that's another favorite of mine out of all of these. And then this one is Sparked. And it's kind of literally just a clear polish with a lot of pink and silver glitter. That's those, and then I have five of the Mega Last. Three are like the older packaging and formula of it. Two are the newer ones. One's a Fast Dry, one's a Color Craze, and one is a Rock Solid. And even though the name's not on it, I still know what it is. Anyway, I'm going to start with the Mega Last. And again, all this stuff is still by Wet n Wild, so bear with me. This is like the older packaging for the Wet n Wild Mega Last nail polishes. which are 0.30 fluid ounces, and versus the newer ones that are 0.45 fluid ounces, and these were $1.99 like the new ones are, and the Wild Chime ones that are 99 cents have 0.43 fluid ounces in them, so I don't see why you would pay more for less product. I don't know. It's probably why they fixed the packaging deal and then they expanded with colors and made the formula a lot better, because these do actually take a little longer to dry, so that does bug me about these. But this one in particular is called Break the Ice, and it's like a white, really shimmery white color with a lot of sparkly, like very thin, tiny glitter in it. The next one, same packaging, is called Candylicious, which I actually think I already have in the newer form. Shit. I'll keep that one to the side, but this is Candylicious, and it's like the same fucking color, I think. Yeah, it's the same color. I feel like a dipshit. And this one is Heat Wave, and it's like a coral color. I'll just skip to the newer Mega Last nail polish packaging ones. This one's I Need a Refresh Mint, and it's like a minty, like robin's egg shell blue. And this one is a favorite of mine for some reason. I like baby blue colors, and I wear them with hot pink, so I could commonly wear these two together, which is the newer Candylicious and the I Need a Refreshment. Like, no shit. Fresh. Mint. It's backwards, but it won't. There's that one. And here's the newer packaging one of fucking Candylicious, because I'm a dipshit and I have two of the same one. But for packaging difference, and, you know, they're both pretty much the same color, as you can see. But one says 209B, and then this one's 209C, so I don't know what the deal with that is, but this one's got 0.45 fluid ounces in it, this one's got 0.30, same price, but they discontinued these to replace them with these, and I think that was a pretty good call, because the formula for these wasn't that great. For these, dries fast, takes forever and a day for it to even chip. I mean, unless you smash your nails on everything, like, it won't chip. It won't move or go anywhere. But that's those, and the kind of the difference between the two is mainly the packaging, how much is in the bottle itself, and the formula. That's pretty much the only difference between the two. But the same price and everything. And I have three more Wet n Wild ones. One is the only fast dry one that I own, which, again, the packaging font shit is coming off the front. It rubs right off, so I don't get that. And this one's the Wonder Yellows. Really bright-ass yellow color. That was actually, no shit, the one that's, like, on my hand. Kind of, still. Can't really see it because I scratched it off, but the next one is a Wet n Wild Color Craze one that they had probably a couple, 2 or 3 years ago, I think. And I got this less than 6 months ago at Mart for like 60 cents because it was in clearance and the bottom of everything that is bad in the world. Or good. One of the two. And this one does not have a fucking name. So, but it is a really pretty fucking neon lime green kind of color. Very shimmery, very awesome. That does dry pretty. Those I were impressed with. I only used two. I ran out of one a really long time ago. But that one, I liked it personally. This one, the name's not on this one either. But I do know it was the Wet n Wild Rock Solid that had like the diamond looking thing on the cap, and they were shaped like this. And with everything that's wet and wild, the thing always rubs off and you can't fucking read it either way. But I don't remember the color name of this, but if I do find it, I will post it because it's definitely been a favorite. It dries really fast. The color is awesome. The only downside to it is it will stain the ever-living shit out of your nails. So, just throwing that out there. But it was a good polish besides that, but that you can get off with, like, rubbing alcohol or something. So it's not too bad. But spinning to the NYC ones. I only have two different collections, I guess, of these. Or like types within the same brand, and most of them are the NYC long wearing nail polishes, and those are the ones I'll start with, and then the other ones are the In a New York Color Minute quick dry polishes, which are pretty good, by the way. So I'll start with one of the NYC long wearing nail polishes. This one is Extra Shiny Top Coat, and this one I absolutely hate. I will throw that out there. I fucking hate this because I could put it on top of a China Glaze nail polish, Wet n Wild one, Revlon one. It makes my polish chip off so fucking easy. Like, this is a shitty top coat. Sucks. And, you know, most of them that I've used are actually pretty good. The rest of them are good, but for some fucking reason, it always makes my shit chip, so I'm going for that. I want it to stay on so I don't have to paint them all the time. Like, this next one is Classic Coral. It's a really pretty pinky, well, it doesn't look really anything coral, it's just very sparkly and pink. Despite the lighting hitting it, like, it looks orange, but it's definitely not orange. Like, right back here is the real color. Something like that anyway. But it's sparkly pink. Stays on pretty good. The next one is Big Money. It's a very frosty kind of colored one. Green, obviously. Because if anything has anything to do with money, it'd be green or like gold or something. Or bronze. But that one works pretty well. The next one is Black Lace, which is a jet black nail polish. That one's okay. This one is Fuchsia Shock, and that one's a hot pink one. This one is pretty good. The next one is Starry Silver, and then there's just a shit ton of just random glitter within it. It's not like a colored nail polish at all. It's pretty clear, but there is a lot of silver, small glitter in it, and giant chunks of purple and deep blue glitter. Some of the purple glitter looks kind of pink though, so there's just a shit ton of glitter in it, and it's good if you like glitter, which I do on nails sometimes. This one's Broadway Burgundy, because again, I have a thing for red. This one is pretty good. Obviously, you can see that I've used it, because it goes to that line. And then the last long-wearing nail polish, enamel, whatever the fuck. It's actually one in an older packaging, because I've had this since freshman year, but it's still, you know, like, has the same consistency as the newer ones. And this one is Purple Pizzazz, and it's a frost one, and it's a really, really pretty purple color. And you can obviously see the packaging difference is just literally the label. But those generally are pretty nice. They're not the best with, like, if you want to wear it for a few days. They chip kind of quick. Probably within like 3 or 4 days is quick for me, because when I paint them, I expect them to not fucking go everywhere, but, you know, in a few days, I'd have a giant piece missing off this nail, a giant piece off this one, little shit off this one, and this one. I don't really like dealing with that. But, anyway, the next ones are the New York Color Minute Nail Polishes. And this one is Flat Iron Green. It looked black when I bought it for some reason, but it's actually green. A really deep green. This one is East Village. It's a really pretty teal color. Or light blue. I don't know. I have a warped perception of my blues, apparently. This one is Golden Glam. It's a really pretty, almost goldy orange color. Peach Sparkle, which is a peach sparkle color, I guess. It's peachy, there's sparkle, so I guess that's right. This one's Radio City Rose, and it's a really pretty deep pink. Whoops, I just knocked my cup over. My bad. City Sweets Pink, which is a cotton candy pink, because again, I have a thing for pinks. And, of course, this one's called Chelsea, which is funny because I have a friend named Chelsea. So I bought her one because it has her name on it. And I find that funny for some reason or another. And, yeah, same as the other ones, but it's just a really pretty deep burgundy kind of color. Skipping on to four of the Sephora and Pantone Universe nail polishes. They came in a set. I got them for my birthday last year. If you go back to like a birthday haul or some shit like that, you'll see the box that they came in, all the other shit. And they came in a really nicely packaged box. I'm not really a big fan of orange, honestly, but these do look decent on my nails in the summer. And I have a black nail art thing, so I could always do some, like, tiger stripe shit on my nail, so it doesn't look as orange and weird. But, there's four of them. They all are very square and ginormous. Because these are 0.50 fluid ounces in each of them. And apparently some kind of weird tangerine orange color was color of the year, according to whatever fucking possessed Sephora to take in orange as a really good color. But there are four different finishes, basically. One is Tangerine Tango, and this is the shimmer one. It's a very shimmery orange color, obviously. This one is Tangerine Tango Cream. This one has basically a finish of a general nail polish that you could buy pretty much at a fucking drugstore and it wouldn't matter. You'd get the same finish. This one is Tangerine Tango Matte, and this one dries matte. Not shiny, not any of that. It's just kind of like a flat color. And this one is a personal favorite out of the four, and this one's Tangerine Tango Glitter, and it's a really pretty orange glitter polish, obviously. And those dry very fast. I'm not hot about orange, but this year the color of the year is like emerald or something. But that I would be into because I wear green on my nails. Besides pinks, blues, reds, shit like that, I can wear green. Like green and black or something like that. But if they come out with a set of four polishes this year, as far as the color of the year thing goes, with the emerald kind of color, I might have to get it because it looks nice. And next is something I'm dreading, but, you know, my fault. And this is all Sally Hansen. Sally Hansen is like the epitome of every color of nail polish ever. It is like the permanent home of any drugstore, and especially nail polish. Like, I know they make other things like, you know, leg self-tanner, you know, fucking What else do they make? I know they make, like, weird makeup kind of shit. Shit for your face. But honestly, I think they should just stick with stuff that has to do with nails, because I've never been let down by any Sally Hansen thing that I've used. So I'll start with the Hard as Nails Extreme Wear nail polishes. And then I'll skip to the Complete Salon Manicure ones, and then there's three other ones that aren't in the same brand, thing, type, line. This one's Red Carpet. It's a really pretty, deep red. A lot of sparkle in it. So it's Fuchsia Power. Very pretty hot pink color, and I've used a significant amount of it. It's down to at least there. Like, there's a line right there, kind of. Right, like where the label's at. Then, Sunkissed, which is a really pretty, brighter orange color than the other ones that I just showed you from Sephora. This one is Blizzard Blue, which I have one that Sally Hansen makes that's just like it, sitting in front of my face, but that's a different type. This one is Twinkle Twinkle, and it's a clear polish, but it has a lot of chunky and fine glitter within it. Very multi-dimensional and all that weird shit. Then, this one's Midnight Sky, and it's kind of like a grayish-black color with a lot of silver sparkle within it. Tealy Cool, which it likes to separate, but that one's like a bluish tinted polish with a lot of multicolored glitter within it. This one is Ivy League, and it's a really pretty brighter lime green color. Then Deep Blue Sea, which is a purpley blue sparkly color. And Emerald City, which is a really dark, beautiful green. That one has sparkle as well, but it's not that detectable in the bottle, and until you put it on your nails you can't really see it that well. But this one's Teeny Greeny Bikini. Really, really nice bright green color, similar to Ivy League. I think it's a little darker though. And this one is a favorite, obviously, because I've used the shit out of it, as you can see. And this one's Set the Stage. And this one's a clear polish, but it has a lot of goldish glitter within it. And I have six of the Complete Salon Manicure polishes that are big and chunky and such. This one in particular is called Lavender Cloud, and it looks pretty white, but it has a very slight purple, very light purple tint to it, but it looks mainly white. Then Paparazzi, and this one is strange because I can never think of how to describe this one in particular, because it's weird. The only thing I can compare it to is, like, rotten eggs. I guess. I don't know. Because it's not white. It's got, like, a weird beige sparkle to it. But it looks a little, like, yellowy. I don't know. I don't even know. I've used it a couple times, but I've thrown a glitter polish on top of it because it looks weird by itself. But I wouldn't even know how to describe that one. But this one's Model Behavior, and it's a favorite of mine out of these, and it's a really pretty lighter blue color. And then this one's Mousseline, something like that, and it's like an off-white. And this one's called First Kiss, And I think for yeah, First Kiss. And that's a very light peachy pink color. Then the last one out of these is the fucking Navy Baby nail polish, which I have a weird love-hate relationship with because of the color. Not because of anything else. These dry extremely fast. These are overall really great polishes. But the problem with this is I bought it thinking it was a deep purple. Because does that not look purple? Okay. And then I put it on my nails. It turns fucking blue. I don't understand. I don't understand at all. Because I'm gonna sit here real quick and swatch it on my desk because I know I'm being deceived because it looks purple whenever you initially put it on your nails, but when it dries it turns fucking blue. I don't know. When I want a purple polish and I put it on and I'm like, ooh yeah, purple, and then it dries and it turns blue, I get pissed because it doesn't go anything else that I put on my nails. Makes me mad. But that's my love-hate relationship with Navy Baby. For some reason, it just pisses me off. But, I'm getting into three that are just different, like, types, but within the Sally Hansen brand. This one is called Lustrous or something. And it's just a Sally Hansen Lacquer Shine nail color. This one is pretty much jet black. I found it at Dollar Tree and I figured, why the fuck not? And it does actually work pretty good, but it's runny, so it does get like everywhere. And this one is one of the hard as nails ones in Frozen Solid. Really pretty light blue color, very sparkly. And last but not least for the Sally Hansen brand is the Diamond Strength No Chip Nail Color and Must Have Iris. And this one's a really pretty light pink with a lot of sparkly stuff in it. Very thin sparkly stuff, mind you, but still sparkly. And I have three of the Forever 21 nail polishes, the Love and Beauty ones. Obviously, they don't really have, like, particular names, really. They're just kind of generally named. Like, this one's called Turquoise, and it's more of a light blue polish, but with a lot of multi-colored glitter within it. Big, chunky glitter. This one's called Patina, and this one is the turquoise one. And this one I have a problem with. Though I love it, it's one of my favorite colors that I own out of my entire nail polish collection. It stains the fuck out of my nails. If I took the polish that's on my nails off right now, you could still see the stain from this from 2 months ago. And it pisses me off because no matter what I rub on it, it won't come off. It just won't. And that's the love-hate relationship I have with that polish. This one, I have the label off the back, but I don't know what it is, but it's like a really pretty golden, like, it's more of a burgundy color, but it's got a lot of golden glitter in it. And then I have four of the Petite nail polish that you can get at, like, Walmart for, like, $1.30 something or whatever. This one's Daze, and it's a really awesome lime green color. Very bright lime green color, by the way. This one looks good over the Wet n Wild Color Craze one that I have. Those two go together pretty well, using this one as the base one and this one to go over it, because this one's a little bit more sheer, so it takes more coats to get it like a full pigmented nail color. But yeah, that's that one. And then another one. Oh, these two are kind of more or less a set, but one is French Pink. This one's French Pink, and then this one's French White. French Pink obviously has a tiny pink tint to it. And French White is for the tips. So obviously that's pretty blank white color. And the other one I have is called Raspberry Rush. And that one, obviously, I've used kind of a lot as well. Though there's only 0.25 fluid ounces in it, I have used a significant amount of it. You kind of see the line right about here. Right above the word petites is how much I've used of it. And it's really more of a darker pink color. I have one L'Oreal one, because I'm lame, and I found it at Big Lots, and it was like $1, so I'm like, okay. And this one is called Silver Sparkle, and it's kind of a white polish whenever you put it on. This can be layered 3 or 4 times to get it to be like a full, like where it fully covers your nail and the white part at the top. And it has a lot of multicolored glitter within it. But you can build this up to be like a full coverage kind of nail polish, where it covers your whole nail without being able to see through it. I have 4 of the Pure Ice ones. 3 I've had for a couple years now, and 1 I bought within the past 6 months. And the one, the newest one anyway, is called Outrageous, and it's a very light, like, lavender color. Then, this one, I'm pretty sure it's called All Nighter, and it's a reddish, burgundy kind of color. This one is, fucking has no name, because the sticker fell off the bottom. But this one's the jet black one that they have. And this other one doesn't have a name either, but it's kind of like a really pearly white color, I guess. Okay. I have 5 Rimmel nail polishes. One I bought very recently, and it's a smaller bottle than the other 4 that I have, but the other 4 I got a couple years ago, so... I'll start with the bigger ones and then go with the newest one last. This one's called Night Before. It's a deep, awesome purple color. And this is from their, like, 60-second dry time line thing that they have. Or had. I don't know what they did with the bigger bottles, because the newer ones are 0.27 fluid ounces and the bigger ones are 0.4. 0.40 fluid ounces. So I don't know what they did with the bigger bottles, or if they still have them, but I know at Walmart now all I have is the smaller ones, but they're $1.50, so it's not bad. But that one is a really, it's kind of got like a golden glitter thing in it, Night Before does, but it's mainly purple. And this one's Stop Traffic, and it's a vinyl shine one, so it dries a little bit to a different finish. I just dropped it. Made a really loud noise. But yeah, Stop Traffic. Really bright fucking pink. This one is Silver Bullet, which is kind of funny and ironic. But it's not really even silver as much as it is a very pearly white color. And this one is Gray Matter, and it's a gray, like a flat-ass gray nail polish. And then the newest one in the 60-second thing, you can significantly see the size difference. This one looks like a monstrous beast, and this one's all small and shit. But this one is in Cupcake Pink. And again, I have a thing with like a cotton candy pink. I don't know. Color like a very cotton candy bright, awesome, fluorescent-ass pink just attracts me and makes me want to go, oh, I want it, okay. Paint my nails a bit. I have 2 oily ones. One I've had for quite a while now, and I've used a shit ton of it. This one's called Twilight, because it's got a stupid-ass name. But it looks like it would be like a light blue color, all around, but it's pretty clear when you put it on your nail, but there is a lot of glitter to it, so it's kind of like a glitter polish or an overcoat. And the next one is in Hookup, and it's this bright ass sunshine yellow color. And there is four of these Sephora by OPI nail polishes. I keep dropping them and it makes a big fucking noise. I'm gonna get yelled at or something. Some of them like to set up. Though I use them, some of them just set up and are generally thick. But the first one is white, and it's a little white blasted, but it's one of those kind of like crackle nail polishes, and it's just a straight up white color. Like it's like paper fucking white. This one is blasted turquoise glitter, and it's literally a turquoise color, same color glitter, and like a crackle nail polish. But the only thing about the white, the two blasted ones that I have, is that they dry really weird and kind of chunky and weird. I don't know. Not the biggest fan of the blasted ones, but, you know, whatever. This one is in What's Your Poinsettia, I think. Kind of like What's Your Poinsettia. Get it? Get it? Okay, anyway. This one is a very similar color to one of the Forever 21 Love and Beauty ones, where it's like a burgundy, deep red kind of color with a lot of golden glitter within it. And the last one is something I got from Caitlin for Christmas, and it says, the name of it is Time for a Nanny, and they spelled time with the spice. And it's kind of like a taupe-ish color. And the next three are China Glaze. China Glaze is a favorite of mine because I just thoroughly enjoy their polishes. This one I have to pitch, sadly, because this one's getting just terrible. But this one is, the fuck was the name of it? I think it was like Hot Flash or some shit like that, or some kind of weird, because I don't know the fucking name of it. I can't. I don't know the fucking name of it, but it was one of those hot pink things. I have to pitch it because it's, you could clearly see that shit is just done. But I'm gonna have to fucking pitch that because it's finished. This one is Vertical Brush, which I like the name of it personally. And it's a really pretty deep red, burgundy color. And this one I bought at Ulta last year sometime, and it's the Crackle Glaze in Black Mesh. And it's a black crackle polish, which works pretty good. And dries very fast, like most of China Glaze. Then I got four Hot Topic nail polishes, or ones that I've bought at Hot Topic. One of them is one of the Warpaint branded ones, Warpaint Beauty, and it's seriously just like a matte nail polish. It's a clear coat, but it makes everything just matte. And I have two of the Blackheart nail polishes, the ones with the skull-shaped bottles. This one I got for Christmas. Doesn't have a name, I don't think, but Caitlin bought it for me for Christmas, pretty sure. And it's a really pretty hot pink. Dries fast, doesn't really chip that much, so I'm cool with it. And this other one is apparently a glow-in-the-dark one. But I got this like last weekend, I'm pretty sure, when I was out with my mom at the mall. And there's like three different colors. There's like a light purple, a mint green, and like a cotton candy pink at the bottom. I'm not too sure. I haven't really used it yet because I have other shit on my nails. And what's funny is I actually shook it And there's a sticker on the top that says do not shake. Because I'm a dipshit, so. And the last one is just, like, a regular Hot Topic nail polish, but it's one of the scented ones that's supposed to smell like kiwi. But it doesn't really smell like kiwi all that much. The last, very last few are four random nail polishes that don't really, I don't know, I don't have like another of them or anything, so they just kind of got grouped together, and there's four of them. One of them doesn't have a fucking name. I don't think any of these actually have a name, but this one came in like one of those color workshop kits, and it's literally just like a weird copper color. I don't know. It's funny and ironic that Mark Williams, the same people that make Wet n Wild, make these, like the Color Workshop shit, but the Color Workshop, like their eyeshadows, shit like that, freaks me out. But when I use Wet n Wild, everything's fine. So, I don't know if it's just made shitty, I don't know. But the same people, no shit, make it. Because if I look on the back of, like, one of the Wet n Wild Mega Glass nail polishes, it says Markman's Beauty. Look on the back of this, Markman's International. So, I don't know if it's just differently made, or, I don't know. But whatever it is, it kind of pisses me off. Then this one is something I picked up at Ross a while ago, and it's Cosmetic Arts nail polish. And there's a shit ton in here. There's 0.5 or 0.50 fluid ounces. This one's a really pretty light blue, very, 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 very shimmery, sparkly, fucking everything under the sun about it is beautiful. It chips a little faster than I would hope. Like, between probably 4 to 5 days is when it starts chipping, but other than that, I don't really have an issue with it. And this one's one of the tiny little bonbon ones. Though, I used to use these a lot as a kid. I think I got it for like 25 cents at Walmart. And it's like a really pretty, frosty, hot pink color. And anyone that uses LA Colors knows that they don't have names for like any of their shit that has to do with anything. But this one I named, personally, I named it Sparkle Sparkle because it's like literally a silver sparkly nail polish. And every time I see it, it reminds me of like Charlie the Unicorn, where those horses are like, or unicorns. Oh, I feel like a dipshit. Where the unicorns are like, sparkle, 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 sparkle. Talking about the amulet. I have a problem. But the last five things are all nail art things. Because I've basically shown all of my nail polish. And it's almost an hour long, so I'm sorry. But I have a lot of shit here, so it's hard to go through it all and be like lightning speed about it. But this one is made by Kiss Nail Art, and it's their paint things. I don't know. These don't have names, but one is white, like straight up white. One of them is black. And then literally one of them is just a silvery sparkle glitter thing. This one is made by LA Colors, one of the Art Deco nail art things. And this one is in baby pink. This one actually has a name. Holy shit. But it's baby pink. And this one is just, it says nail art by Diamond Cosmetics. My grandma got it for me from like Dollar Tree, so I'm like, okay. And it literally says just gold glitter. And it literally is just gold glitter. But that seriously is my whole fucking nail polish collection. I have so much shit. So I'm sorry that this video is so fucking long, but like, I have so much shit, and I needed to reorganize it anyway, so I figured while I had it out and organized, I would just put it back on the thing, and fix it, do what I needed to do, so. yeah, hope you guys enjoyed that shit, because I've been talking for quite a while. And I will see you guys whenever I feel like making my next video. Peace. Peace. I feel like a dipshit.